I'm gonna tell y'all right now, I know I'm kind of backlit right here, but what I'm doing today is that it's cold out. You see, I got a sweatshirt on and stuff. It's not freezing, but it's a day that we had a cold front come through, and now it's starting to warm up after. We got high pressure coming up on us, and a lot of people have a hard time catching fish when these conditions happen. So I'm gonna show you a way to catch redfish, might catch speckled trout too, but we're gonna show you how to do it. When cold fronts come through, the water's cool, and these fish, how do you catch them? And there's a couple of things that you can do and replicate it as a pattern all day long and catch fish. You can see this fish right here, this red, he's hardly even fighting because he's so cold. Look at him. And one of the things I'll show you right now as I'm doing it is that the jig head itself, I'm fishing on bottom because these fish, they lay on the bottom. So I've got a jig head, just a straight jig head tied on. Get him in here. I got a straight jig head tied on. Now he wants to get anxious on me. But I've got a jig head tied on just straight onto the hook. I'm gonna get it off here. I got a really good jig head on here. Okay. Nice fish. I'm gonna release him real quick. Beautiful red fish right there. Gorgeous wintertime red. We're gonna let him go. Got a little active there at the end. But right here, first thing, I use a chartreuse jig head. I know you might think that doesn't make a difference. I've been doing this for 30 years. I promise you, during the wintertime, chartreuse, white, or red, orange, those three colors work extremely well in the wintertime. But chartreuse is my go-to. Now, let's show you what we're doing for bait. All right, now, what we're using for bait, we've got just a regular jig head. This is a 3/8 ounce jig head. I like 3/8 ounce. I do very well with that in current conditions. And just during the winter, it holds a bait on the bottom. I'm using dead shrimp. We bought this from our local marina, Campos Marina. You can buy them. They come in a little box, and I think it gives us 2 pounds. There's different ways that people hook up dead shrimp. I do it a lot like I do with my live shrimp. I go right through the tail, right at the top. I make sure that my hook is as close to the backbone of this one. It doesn't have a backbone, but the back of the shrimp. And what I want to do is that gets the meat part onto it. As soon as that shrimp hits the straight part of the hook, I come out. I don't want it curled up. And the reason for it is that if it was curled on this, it would spin. Not that it's got to look natural, but it would spin and it would actually just, you know, tighten up my line. I'd have twist all up in my line, and then you know, you'll have break offs due to that. Whereas if it's straight like this, when you're throwing it out, it'll be presented correctly and the fish will eat it. So I'm gonna show you in just a second the scenario that I'm doing here, okay? What I'm doing is I'm fishing, I've got a flat right here, okay? There's grass all up on this flat right here. So I know my current is coming around this flat. It's only about 1.5 feet deep right here. It comes across this flat, it passes through all of this grass, so it gets oxygenated, the water, as it's going through, plus the grass filters the water, makes it clean for me. Whereas if I went to a point further down, the water would be dirty because the water in the main lake is dirty. So up here in the bank, my water is going through this grass, it's passing through, it's hitting this point, and then you can see the current on the point right there. Those fish are laying right where that current line is. That's where they're at. And what they're doing is they're waiting for anything to come out of this grass. The water is actually oxygenated, it's clear, and it's actually gonna warm up. As the sun gets up, this dark bottom here, it's a mud bottom, is gonna heat up. So if the fish were out in the lake out here, they might be 5 or maybe 10 degrees colder than up here on this flat where the water's coming off, going through the current. It gives a great scenario of a lot of variables that go all together to produce a spot that catches fish. I hope you understand that, because this is a great scenario. I use this all the time in my charters. I used it when I was fishing a lot of tournaments. It just works really well coming from real shallow, going down into not deep, deep water, but it's just that it's two things. The grass, the warmth of the water, coming through, these fish are sitting here and they're just waiting for something to happen. Let me see if I can get me another one. I'm dropping the bait right on the current line, right in front of it. There's a little bit of grass right there also. And then what I'm doing is, it's really not that I'm moving the bait. I'm just kind of hopping it a little bit to where they can see it happening, because it's dead shrimp. They're gonna actually smell it. They're not gonna really, this isn't a visual deal. This is more or less like I'm kind of dead sticking it. I'm letting it sit out there for a few seconds. If I don't get a bite, I kind of hop it a little bit, and knowing that while I throw it out, my bait is getting pulled also with the current. So once I get kind of out off the current line, I'll retrieve my shrimp back in, throw back up, and let it do it again. These fish are sitting there, and most people would say, hey, would a popping cork work better? Absolutely, a popping cork would probably work better. But during the winter time, the thing about working straight tight line like this with a shrimp on the bottom, to me, is that you get to feel that strike. It's just a different style of fishing, you know, and I just really enjoy it. I may not get the strikes that I would with a popping cork, but that doesn't matter. I'm not here trying to fill a boat. I'm here just trying to get the strikes, figure these fish out, and understand what they're doing. And then if I had customers out here or my kids, I'd be like, yeah, let's throw it here with a cork and catch them. But I want to really kind of figure it out, and I just enjoy that strike when you're on tight line and compared to fishing with a cork when you see the cork go under. All right, I'm getting a bite right now, okay? He's barely hitting it, like he's trying to take it. I may open up my line, let him have a little bit of line for a second. He's trying to get it. I'm gonna feel for him. I don't feel him on it. Nope, he was hitting it. Oh, there he goes, he hit it again. He's just trying to grab it. There he is, he hit it hard the second time. Here's another fish right here, he's on that bottom. Now I'll tell y'all, he's gotta find that bait sitting there on the bottom, okay? So what that's telling me is that how sluggish he was to bite that bait, it took him a little bit. That's a lot telling me, oh, this is a sheep's head. That's telling me that the fish are kind of sluggish. Now sheep head bites like that a lot also, so that could have just been a sheep head bite, but it's the same thing. You know, this sheep head, he struck that dead shrimp on the bottom, you know, and this is good table fare if people like eating sheep head. This is a decent sized one, you know, and you can catch these. He's very cold, y'all. When I touch him with my hand, he is super cold. So that lets me know that the water is really chilled. So here he is. I'm gonna throw him back. All right, buddy, we're gonna put another shrimp on and see if we can do this again. Oh, there he is. All right, another one coming to me. Nice little red. Now, y'all, this scenario now is what you have to think about is that you could do this anywhere. I mean, this is a very easy thing to find. You could just pull out a map. Let's get him in. Nice little keeper red. But you could do this over and over. I mean, honestly, you know, you find a point. You find that where there's a flat ahead of it. You know, because this is just a big cove on a straight point. So we got this big cove. This water just kind of rolls in, comes off of this point. It's coming from where I have a little bit of grass, maybe a little oyster in there too, coming off, dropping through, and these fish are sitting there. But I'm telling you, the deepest water here is about 2 foot, maybe. So it's shallow, shallow water, okay? So you want to make sure that you understand that the shallow water is kind of the key. The temperature's warmer. That water gets oxygenated by the grass and it gets cleaned up where the grass filters out any sediment that's in there. And these fish just hold in there waiting for something to eat. He's cold, y'all, and he's loving some dead shrimp. We're gonna throw him back, let him eat for another day. This is awesome. Great scenario. Oh, jumped in. See you later, buddy. Oh, there's one right there. So y'all, this is a great scenario. This is a great way. This is a great way for you to catch fish during, let's just say you want to use this technique from cold winter days up until getting into the spring. Okay, this small little red right here. And into the spring. I mean, I've been fishing here 10 minutes. I've caught 4 fish, I think, and I missed a couple of them with these real slow bites. But these fish are gonna sit flat, coming up. But not deep. This lake is only about 3 foot deep. Coming off about a foot, foot and a half, dropping down and going out on that little spot right there. We got grass, oyster, and we've got mud bottom. Water heats up, clears up, water comes off. The fish sit right there. I mean, it's a bottleneck effect. I mean, it's truly something that you would honestly think this is where fish would be. And they're there, okay? Now, not to say this won't work in the summer and in the spring. I mean, in the fall, summer and fall, but I will tell you, it's way better when the water's cool and warming up instead of being warm and cooling down, if that makes sense, okay? So this is a more or less winter to spring type of scenario to use, okay? So make sure you do that. This is a nice little fish. We can throw him back, just like all the other ones we caught today. Beautiful fish today. Make sure, whatever y'all do, y'all wanna make sure that y'all subscribe to my channel. We'll put some quotes down here if we need anything. You know, y'all ask us questions. I love when you ask me a question that I have the ability to do a show about it, because that lets me know what you're wanting to know to become a better fisherman, and that's what I'm here for. Beautiful fish. We're gonna go try some other techniques in just a few minutes, but this is something great for you to have the ability to fish from right now, wintertime, through the spring. I'll see y'all on water.